once I got started on graffiti, I just couldn't stop, and it's like an addiction, really. As soon as I knew it, I was just tagging everywhere.
You know, it becomes what you are rather than what you do. It's all about how I can make my name stand out above all the rest.
Graffiti's definitely not a crime. I mean, I don't paint on anybody's vans, anybody's houses.
Public place, I have to consider what I'm painting, so I won't go and draw something inappropriate near to a kid's playground. So I'll generally get quite good feedback. Obviously, you get the one or two people who don't like it, but that's just the nature of graffiti. The future of graffiti, I see it getting more and more popular, really, because it's been opened up to the masses now. Free and Banksy always gets mentioned in at least one of these interviews, and basically what he's done is brought more people aware of what they're doing, so what's going on with the scene, and people are now starting to accept it more as an art form. When they did the Sino Evil event, there was thousands of people who came from all over England to come and have a look at the artwork, so it could definitely pull people in. If there's world-class artists exhibiting outside, then it'll definitely give people reason to come to Bristol.
I think the transient nature of it, that it actually changes regularly a lot of the time, is really good. You know, because when people walk down the same street, they've got something that changes, and it's not just mundane and the same.